All good?
Yep.
Let's do this thing. Hi, I'm Ty Nelson, and I'm the co-founder of Florida Fishing Products, and this is my story. I was pretty blessed as I was being raised. I was actually born and raised on the Caloosahatchee itself, right on the river. So I spent a lot of time wade fishing in the backyard. Remember, we used to cast net into our lake. We'd catch small tilapia and bluegill, and then we'd take them down to our docks. We'd actually chum up the shorelines and get these snook busting up on the surface. We'd throw mid-sized tilapia at them. We'd catch these 35 to 40 inch snook, which today is a huge fish, but back then it was just, they're absolute monsters. I remember my freshman year of high school, I actually decided not to play baseball. The whole goal was like I was not going to play baseball so I could focus my efforts on fishing. That was just my passion at the time. I was pulling down the shoreline behind my dad's house and I see this log of a 45 inch snook, and I cast a perfect cast in front of it and twitch it in front of the fish's face. And I mean, it had to have been 14 inches in front of this snook's mouth, and it just opened up and hailed the Rapala twitching rat that I was throwing. And it just sent me on this sleigh ride. It was pulling the Ginu left and right, and luckily had moved away from the shoreline and just took me straight out to deeper water. And I actually landed this fish with just one hook barely caught in the corner of the fish's mouth. And I got my bow grip, I reached as far as I could, and I got the grip on the fish, and I slung him into the Ginu and paddled as fast as I could back to my mom's house. And I put the fish in the water, and I started yelling for my mom. She came out and took this picture of this 45 inch massive snook. And really, that's where my obsession for sight fishing started. And anyone who knows me knows when I'm on the water, I would rather spend time looking for fish to sight fish to than spending all day casting at a shoreline or catching bait and sitting and waiting and trying to get a bite. For me, it's all about the hunt. But moving forward, I graduated from high school at North Fort Myers High School, and I ended up going to UCF. One of my favorite things during that time in college is I would always come back to my roots in Southwest Florida, and I'd focus on snook fishing. I mean, I would spend day after day going after these schools of snook and really spending the time to figure out what these fish were doing. It's no secret that during the summer months, you have the full moon in May, June, and July, and you get big schools of fish on the beaches and some of the backcountry bays. And that was something that I always loved to do. It's something I've really, really gotten into the last 10 years, and I've just really focused on heavily that time of year. I mean, what we do is we figure out techniques on how to get these fish to eat anyways. And we also figure out techniques on how to get to the fish without them knowing that we're there. And recently we've learned that using a drone is actually a phenomenal way to find the fish. This last time we were out, we got some phenomenal footage of schools of snook, big, big snook, which was some of the coolest footage I've ever seen, and something I've been really trying to do with Jack Brack and our videographer for probably 2 years now. That was the first thing I told him I wanted to do, is I wanted to fish schools of snook using the drone. And finally the opportunity came this spring, and we were able to get out there, and we found just tons and tons of snook. It was crazy. I mean, they're just stacked upon stacked upon stacked. At one point we probably saw nearly 400 fish in one school. We primarily were throwing twitch baits at them, which is my go-to for snook. It's a soft twitch bait, the Slayer Ink Sinister Twitch Bait, STB. They have that crazy action that gets that reaction strike from the fish. But for me, I really want to throw artificial at these fish because it just gives you a better appreciation for them. It's a more difficult style of fishing, and ultimately when I get home, and I can say I hooked that fish and landed that fish on an artificial bait, that I tricked that fish using an artificial bait, you know, that's something that it just always gets me excited. And I can just run through my mind over and over again the different eats I've gotten, some of the craziest bites I've gotten. I mean, just when we were fishing the other day, you know, I'm standing on the bow and we're looking at 25 snook, I mean, within 15 feet of the boat, and they're staring right at us, and I'm just working this bait hard, just twitch, 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 and one of them just slammed it. All three of us were watching this fish as it ate. And I mean, it was just epic. There's nothing better. The line starts peeling off, the snook starts jumping and thrashing its head. It's really just a phenomenal game fish, a fish that I've just really been blessed to have been able to been raised catching over, you know, the last 26 years of my life. But really, that's that sport and focusing specifically on that fish, that is really what has driven me to where I am today. You know, I spent time as a kayak angler and spent time as a tournament angler in a bay boat. You know, I spent time as a marketing intern working for Hell's Bay Boatworks and met some wonderful people there and learned a lot about the fishing industry there. But none of those things truly led to where we are today. It was being born and raised on the Caloosahatchee and being able to experience that river firsthand and seeing it as it thrived at its very best and then as it has died, as we've seen year in and year out the last few years. That is what's really driven me to get to where I am today and to start this company. Conservation-wise, we've been lacking here in Florida, and I've seen it firsthand on the Caloosahatchee River when we dump Lake Okeechobee water. I've seen the red tide and the blue-green algae. I've seen it just decimate our fish stocks. I've seen it over in Mosquito Lagoon and Indian River and Banana River as well. Same thing, a little different type of algae, the brown algae. No matter what the news tells you at the end of the day, it is human impact. Yes, some of these algae are naturally occurring, but it's very unnatural at the rate that they're occurring. They're being sped up by us putting pollutants into the water, basically fertilizers for these algae blooms to continue to grow and grow and grow. And what it does a lot of times, it either wipes out the dissolved oxygen, which kills the fish, or the red tide itself, which I don't know as well about. It has whatever in it that causes the fish to die in at massive proportions when it gets really bad, which we've seen here the last few years. You know, it made me look around and look at what I was purchasing as a consumer, as an angler. And you know, we're looking at these products. A lot of them are you know, foreign made. A lot of them are foreign owned. A lot of them are corporate owned or conglomerate owned, these companies. And they have a lot of money backing them. They make a lot of money off the fishing industry and off of our estuaries. And it's so rare to see them actually give back to the fishing industry. And that's something that really rubbed me the wrong way and rubbed Tim, one of my good friends, the wrong way. When I graduated from UCF and Tim approached me to start a business, you know, he said, what do you want to do? Like, I know that we should start something together. We've always had a passion to start a business. We're very like-minded individuals. And I think we had unique skill sets that complemented each other. And so when he came to me, we put our heads together and quickly we thought about pretty much the same thing. We're like, we should get into the fishing industry. We should look at producing fishing reels, and we should look at giving back to conservation and helping fight for the health of our estuaries. Because if we're pissed off as anglers, I know that there are others out there that are pissed off as well. When Tim and I sat down and we began really this process of coming up with a business plan, you know, we thought spinning reels was the way to go. Every single angler, just about every single angler, starts with a spinning reel. And we want to have maximum impact. We want to be able to have every angler know and teach every angler how to be a conservation-minded angler. And so we thought that was a good product to start with. And not to mention, there's really no small local spinning reel companies that are doing well. There are small local fly companies and rod companies and line companies, but no one was doing spinning reels. So Tim and I put our heads together and we decided we wanted to focus on three pillars: community, customer service, and conservation. And that's when we began Florida Fishing Products.